You got it all. Thank you.
Go.
Happy birthday, Bobby.
Oh, yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I'm getting a little bit older.
And wiser.
Yeah, that too. But I'm always learning though, because you know, I find out I was pre-diabetic, and now I gotta become wise and knowledgeable about eating healthy. You know, cause I've been eating well, I've been eating for 40 years, so I'm like, you know, now I gotta learn something new and unique. But we'll get on that a little bit later, talking about some healthy stuff. Right now, I'm gonna get on her. So welcome to the Bobby Buck Show, outside Catfish 21, down here in Skid Row. Of a 5th and Central. Place is great.
Oh,
they handle business,
yeah.
And they treat the people of Skid Row proper.
Yes, they do.
Excellent. So, but we get with this person right here, who's going to be performing at my birthday party on August the 5th, coming straight out of Skid Row, Miss Joe Clark, AKA Skid Row's Michael Jackson.
Hello.
Yeah. So I'm so glad that you could be stepping on out to do your thing.
I'm always honored. I can't say that enough.
Right. So let all these people know, all the people that know me, they gotta learn you, about you and who you are. So give people a little bit of your background of where you come from. How are you the Michael Jackson of Skid Row?
Well, I'm getting a little short, right? Okay. Testing.
I told you gotta talk loud. You gotta do a little bass in the morning. But you got your microphone. Getting young, just getting well. No.
Yeah, right. Well,
leave me alone.
Yeah. Okay. Happy birthday once again. I may have fans out there that remember me from La Paz or Fall. That's how I got my professional beginning. Michael Bruno was one of the producers. That right there, you know, set me up, you know, to become the professional that I was and hope to become again. But I'm at the point where, you know, I need a lot of financing, you know.
Right.
I need
right.
to get back to the rehearsal and getting into studio and getting it tighter
right.
the way it should be. You know, I'm good, but I would like great.
Right.
Greater. So, you know, I need to make up the costumes and stuff like that. So, you know, once I get some funding and get back to the caliber of what I'm used to doing, it'll be awesome. I've come a long way, but I still got a long way to go. You know, and if God's will, if this is what God wants me to do, and it makes people happy, I just want to be good at it.
Well, kind of give people, you want to give people a little of your background, because you're now housed, but you was living down here in Skid Row, wasn't you?
Yeah, I was down here for about 20 years, actually.
For 20 years?
20 years, and what it was, you know, a couple of loved ones in my family passed away, including my sister, the one that got me into children. So I kind of took it hard, you know, so I went into a deep depression. And that deep depression lasted, you know, 15, 20 years, you know. And, you know, don't get me wrong, the whole time I was working, trying to get off the streets, and it wasn't as easy as they say. You know, some
right.
venues make it really hard for a person to get off the street. But you really got to want to do it. But I got lucky through the Midnight Mission. They're the ones that helped me get off the street. And I've been at my housing now for 2 years.
Props to Midnight Mission, for that program. What's the name of that program?
The Bridge. It's called The Bridge.
The Bridge. So they still using that?
Oh, yeah. It's still successful.
Okay.
You know, they have a men's program. They, you know, have, from what I hear, have one of the best programs around.
Okay.
But, so I just have to be at the right place at the right time.
Well, I got afraid. I tell people what I had to learn, because I myself used to live in Skid Row. But they open up a whole new can of spirituality for me. And I tell people, when things that happen in spiritual timing, and it's all pertaining to your own spirituality, because we all different individuals, so we all have our own timing. See, and life is not about competing against individuals. Because we all got our own struggle that we got to deal with. So, like I say, we all trying to get to a certain place in our own lives.
It's amazing that you brought up a spirituality part, because, you know, although I was raised in the church.
Yeah.
I was made to pray and, you know, be godly and all of that, okay? But yeah. I didn't find God within myself until I came here to skip up.
Oh.
You know, so then I found my own, I found God by experience, you know, and I most of it before.
Yeah.
Because nobody can tell you. There's something that you gotta find out for yourself. And I learned that. I really did. Yeah. And God has kept me from a lot. Trust me, being a female down here in Skid Row is not easy. But the love for what I do, the love for Michael, the love for God, all of that, you know, has kept me going, and that's where I
am. Yeah.
It gives me hope, something to look forward to.
Yeah.
It's not easy.
No, it's not. Because like I tell people, I went through spiritual boot camp, is what I call
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
Yeah.
Skid Row was my spiritual boot camp.
Yeah. And you know, instead of just calling people homeless people, I like to use the phrase street angels.
Because, that's a good way to put it. That's a very positive way.
Yeah, because I'm not from here. And like I said, I ain't the smartest person in the world. Like people try to, you know, brag, you know, I'm a hustler and all that. No, I was guided.
Me too.
I was guided.
That's why I say,
proper,
you know,
information
not,
from different
I
people.
I know better than, you know, at one time I did have a certain amount of greatness, you know, because I was at that caliber at one time.
Right.
You know, been around the world a couple times and all that.
Okay,
but I think maybe now with the mental and the spiritual education that I have, you know, I think I could be even better than I was.
You know what, you can, because back in the day, I didn't know
a lot of things that I know now.
See, I thought I knew a lot, but
right.
Like when I first got here, I was ready to take over Hollywood, like everybody
right,
did first
right.
day.
Right, and I did for a minute, so I thought.
Yeah.
Okay, now, you know, I think I can take it over in the right way.
Yeah.
You know, in the spiritual way. Hopefully, if somebody sees me and they're happy and they love them as much as I do, then I guess I'm doing what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah, and especially what you're doing, Michael Jackson, because it's kind of funny, we don't really pay attention. We do a little bit when people are alive, and when they die, it's when you really kind of dig in and research and stuff. So, you know, Michael Jackson was around, but I was more about like Tupac and Prince were my two favorite artists. But then when Michael died, you know, I started listening to his music.
Right.
I paid attention. I was like, oh, now I get it. So I had to put Michael in there, but you know, but I was more, I related more like with Tupac and Prince.
Yeah.
But I see where Michael, was coming from. And I said, okay, now I get it. So now when I listen to his music and stuff, oh yeah, when we first got here, we were sitting here chopping it up a little bit. Some dude put up in a tight car playing Michael Jackson, playing bass. I said, Michael is calling you.
That kind of thing happens all the time.
Right.
Well, I could just be talking about him or thinking about him, and next thing I know, I hear a song. By the way, his birthday was a couple days ago. Happy birthday. So,
okay.
Yeah, August 29th.
Well, now it's coming up then.
What's today?
She's in her own zone, her own world. She got her own calendar.
Pretty much. Wait, what's today?
Yeah, you're confused by me. I'm like,
wait a minute, what?
It's July.
Oh, my head on my
head. I'm thinking back. Wait a minute,
July 23rd.
Was it June 23rd? I think it was June 23rd. Yeah, because I remember
I'm a month ahead of myself.
You're in between months. I think June when he died, his birthday in August, you in July. but not because you bringing me back, because it was happening in 2009. I know that much when he died. Because believe it or not, I was in the nursing home. I was in the nursing home with my life.
Wait.
Yep, because I was recuperating from a hip replacement, my left hip. They took it out, put another one in. And I was just trying to flirt with the nurses. One nurse looked at me and said, "Man, I feel like, how you trying to flirt? You ain't got no hip." I thought about it, yeah, it was right.
That's funny. You thought you was the man and you can't even do nothing.
I was premeditating, you know, futuristic thing. You know,
yeah, see, I guess that's what it is.
So, I wonder what's getting
at. What's going to happen in August? Because I'm sure I'm thinking this is August.
Well, you're performing in August. That's something that's going to happen. And I'm telling you, maybe something big. What's going to happen is somebody's going to see the video and go reach out with their heart and their funds to help you go to the next level.
That would be wonderful.
Coming from Skid Row. 20 years of Skid Row on these streets as a female, as a woman, as a young lady out here. So what we're going to do one day, we'll get a real, real sit down to really get into some history with her, because being a woman down here in Skid Row all the years.
Well, you know, that eventually will come out.
Yeah.
Laura Hunt, my
writer.
That's
right. She's working on a book already.
It's going to be called My Life as a Man in the Middle.
Okay. Wow. Okay. That's what's up.
Yeah. As told by me telling it to Laura Hunt.
Okay.
She's a writer. And I met her at the Midnight Mission. Do one session like this, you know, someone asking me about my, you know, experience down here, and she got interested, and we became good friends.
Okay. Yeah, I met some real cool people.
Yeah, she's really, she seems to be really interested in what I'm doing and what I'm about.
Okay.
Which makes me feel good, you know, that I'm doing something like that.
Yeah. No, because, you know, on the spiritual tip with everything, that's why, you know, we always had like a little connection anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And then we kept on saying each year, this and this and that.
Yeah. And one of these years, it's going to be.
It's going to pop. See, I tell you about it, for this year, 2018 is amazing. But next year, 2019, will be exciting. 2019 will be exciting. Everything is going to fall in place.
2019?
Hey, we need to get a 2020 thing. We need to skip over 2019. It'll be. Now we get 2021.
It's still July.
Yeah.
I thought it was August.
It's the last day. Hold on. Tomorrow the 1st, I think. August. I got a bad trip. You make me sick in here. My mind ain't always
there. I think tomorrow's in
Okay, well, I can't remember because I've got the camera goes off and on, so we might have been talking and y'all missed a whole lot of stuff. But like I say, you got to get it. She's writing a book. I don't know if y'all got that part or not. But everything we were talking about, if y'all didn't get it, y'all going to have to buy it. Y'all going to have to buy the book.
There's a lot of people down here, like young men, that I just spoke to, and you know, have seen me when I came down here, and you know, they know my potential. You know, and they always said, you know, give it a pop, you know, you look good, you know, and that's because I help. But anyway, I gotta about to say about the three songs she's ready to do on my birthday on August 5th. She's ready to do it, and I told her between all three songs we can get her a water break.
She said she can do it though.
I can do it because I mean back in the day when I first started, when I was rehearsing, I didn't do it. I used to make myself rehearse for hours without stopping. For this, that's what I did the other day when I was for August.
Okay.
I made myself rehearse for hours.
Okay.
So my lady, I'm a little short. But when I go home, better believe I'm gonna get my little speaker thing. I'm definitely gonna
I'm going to definitely prepare for it, and I'm going to have to do just like you guys, you know, I know when he gets tired. You know how to just kick back and just move with it, you know. But without the audience even knowing, I'm taking a break. I know how to do that. Okay, okay. Now, you'd be real smooth with it, and like I've been watching your last performances, and like even people who see you for the first time, they'd be like, wow. Yeah, so I mean, no, she really puts it in, gets it in, and you know, she turns it up.
Okay. Michael, Skid Row's own Michael Jackson.
Eternal. Say it again!
Michael Jackson.